Students, today we will study some small topics like identities and quadratic equations in two variables like that. What is identity? We have already learned many identities, like right from the childhood, a plus b whole square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. That is identity. Sine square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. So actually, if we look at these, sine square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. So if you are asked, then find the value of theta. So what should be your answer? It is true for any value of theta. So an equation becomes an identity if it is true for every value of the variable. As we say, a plus b whole square formula, which is called formula also, it is true for any value of a and b. So let's study how to handle identity in case of polynomials. The equation ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0 is an identity if this equation is an identity, means it is satisfied for every value of x. So how it is possible? Can we think if all the coefficients are 0? Okay. The equation ax square plus bx plus c equal to dx square plus ex plus f is an identity if, see, same thing, a equal to d, b equal to e, and c equal to f. These both results are same. Here, on the one side of equation, we have 0, and here, both sides contains the terms of x. So we can write this equation as a minus dx square plus b minus ex plus c minus f equal to 0. So what for identity? For identity, a minus d equal to 0, b minus e equal to 0, c minus f equal to 0, which lead us to a equal to b, a equal to d, b equal to e, and c equal to f. Okay. If we have expressions on both sides of equal to sign, then for identity, we can equate the corresponding coefficients. What do we mean by corresponding coefficients? In left side, कोफिशियंट ऑफ एक्स स्क्वायर इज ए इन राइट साइड, कोफिशियंट ऑफ एक्स स्क्वायर इज डी, सो ए इक्वल टू डी एंड सो ऑन. नाउ एंड nth डिग्री इक्वेशन हैज एग्जैक्टली n रूट्स इंक्लूडिंग ऑल, इंक्लूडिंग ऑल दैट इज इंक्लूडिंग रियल इमेजिनरी एंड रिपीटेड. सी एन nth डिग्री इक्वेशन हैज एग्जैक्टली n रूट्स, नीदर द नंबर ऑफ रूट्स इज लेस देन n नॉर द नंबर इज नंबर ऑफ रूट्स इज ग्रेटर देन n, एग्जैक्टली n रूट्स. सपोज consider an equation like x square minus 2x plus 1 equal to 0. It is a quadratic equation. We can write this also as x minus 1 whole square 0. So we say that only one root, but one is the root which is repeated two times. Similarly, if we write x cube equal to 0, then the only root is 0 which is repeated three times. X equal to 0, 0, 0. If an nth degree equation has more than n roots, more than n roots, then it is an identity. Okay. In case of here it seems to be quadratic. Why I have said seems? Because for identity A is 0, B is 0 and C is 0. So if A is 0, that will not be a quadratic equation. So in some questions, they say like this. If the equation a square minus 4x square plus a square minus 3x minus 10 a square plus 10x minus 16 equal to 0 is an identity, then find the value or values of A minus plus 16. Now, see, this question can also be written as if the equation A square minus 4x square plus A square minus 3x minus 10x, 10A. It is A. these are a sixteen equal to zero has more than two roots, or say more than two roots. Quadratic will have exactly two roots. If it is more than two roots, then it is an identity. Then find the value or values of A. Okay. A square minus 4x square plus A square minus 3A minus 10 plus A square plus 10A plus 16 equal to 0. Fine. Both are same. For identity, A square minus 4 equal to 0. What are the values of A from here? 2 minus 2. A square minus 3A minus 10 equal to 0. What are the values of A? Minus 2, 5, and A square plus 10A plus 16 equal to 0, minus 2, minus 8. Okay, we have equated all the coefficients by 0. Now, which value of A we should take? See, the condition for this equation to be an identity is coefficients equal to 0. All the coefficients. So, we must take the common of these three for which all the coefficients will be 0. So, our answer is that is A equal to minus 2. It is very much obvious that if it is true for every value of x and put A equal to B equal to C 0, it will get satisfied. Fine. Let's take another example. Find the condition on coefficients such that the expression x power 4 plus ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d is a perfect square. Okay, see, this is a 4 degree expression, and if it is a perfect square, then it must be the square of an expression of degree 2. That is, it must be the square of a quadratic expression. So, we can assume that okay, why we have chosen the coefficient of x square as 1? Because here the coefficient of x power 4 is 1. So, here also. And what do you think? We have written this expression just as this. So, don't you think it is an identity in x? Okay. So, we have x power 4 plus ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d is equal to, apply the formula, x power 4 plus 2lx cube plus 2m plus l square x square plus 2lm x plus m square. Okay. These two expressions are same expression. So we have equating the coefficient of like terms, both sides, like terms, both sides, we have A equal to 2L, B equal to coefficient of x square, 2m plus L square, C equal to coefficient of x, which is 2LM, and D equal to constant term, which is m square. Now, our question is, find the condition on coefficients, means find a condition involving A, B, C or D, but not involving L and M, because these things, L and M, is being introduced by us. So we must eliminate LM. Can we eliminate L and M? See, here, C square is 4L square, M square. And what is 4L square? 4L square, we can say that it is nothing but A square. And what is M square? D. So this is the required condition for which this 4 degree expression will be a perfect square of a quadratic expression. Now let us take another example. Consider the rational trigonometric expression 3 cos x minus 4 sin x plus 1 by 4 cos x plus 2 sin x minus 3. If numerator equal to lambda into denominator plus mu into derivative of denominator, nator plus nu, then find the values of lambda, mu and nu. Okay. Means numerator 3 cos x minus 4 sin x plus 1 is equal to lambda into denominator. Lambda into what is denominator? 4 cos x plus 2 sin x minus 3 plus mu into derivative of denominator. What is the derivative of denominator? Differentiation of 4 cos x plus 2 sin x minus 3. So what's that? Minus 4 sin x plus 2 cos x plus nu. So it is nothing but we have written this expression as right hand side. So since this is an identity, because this expression only has been written in this form. It is true for all values of x. Since it is an identity, therefore, equating coefficients of like terms both sides. Coefficient of like term both sides. See the coefficient of cos x on the right hand side. 4 lambda its derivative is 2 cos x minus 4 sin x plus 2 cos x. So, coefficient of cos x on right hand side is 4 lambda plus 2 mu. Okay. And what is the coefficient of cos x in left side? 3. So, 4 lambda plus 2 mu equal to 3. And what about coefficient of sin x? See, 2 lambda minus 4 mu. 2 lambda minus 4 mu on right hand side, and left side it is minus 4. And now, constant term. What is the constant term in the right hand side? Minus 3 lambda plus nu. And what is the constant term on left hand side? 1. So, we can now find the values of lambda, mu and nu by these three equations. Now, another small topic is Descartes' rules of science. Descartes' rules of science. You can also pronounce it as Descartes' rule of science. There is nothing in the pronunciation. Understand what is this. It is regarding a polynomial equation. The maximum number of positive real roots of the polynomial equation f of x equal to 0 is equal to the number of sign changes among coefficients. What is the meaning of sign change among coefficients? We will see through examples. Okay. Now, the number of positive roots is equal to either the maximum number or less than that by an even number. I am writing just the statements. Okay. Now, it is about maximum number of positive real roots. The maximum number of negative real roots roots of f of x equal to 0 is equal to the sign changes among coefficients of f of minus x. Okay. The number of negative roots is equal to either the maximum number or less than that by an even number. This is the statement. Just it is a simple statement, you have to remember, that's it. For example, consider f of x 2x power 7 minus 3x power 6 plus x power 5 minus x power 4 minus 5x cube minus 7x square plus 8x minus 10. Say this is f of x. Now, number of sign changes among coefficients. Here it is plus, it is minus. One sign change. Here it is minus, it is plus. Observe carefully. Here it is, this coefficient is minus 3, this is 1. So again 1. Here also there is a change from plus to minus. Here no change. Minus, 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 no change. Okay, here it is. And here also. So, how many sign changes in f of x? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. See, 5. So, now come to the statement. The maximum number of positive roots. Maximum number of positive roots. So you can answer without calculating the roots of the equation f of x equal to 0. We can say that maximum number of positive roots is 5. Okay? Therefore, number of positive roots of f of x equal to 0 can be, see, maximum number is 5. It can have less than 5 positive roots also. Okay. Now come here. The number of positive roots is equal to either the maximum number or less than that by an even number. The number of positive roots can be 5 or less than 5. Less than 5 means not 4, less than by an even number. Means what? 5 less than an even number, 2. So 5 minus 2, 3. Positive roots can be 3 or less than that, 1. Can there be not any positive root? 0 number of positive roots? Not possible. Okay. So there number of positive roots of f of x can be 5, 3 or 1. Less than by an even number, less than by an even number from the maximum number possible. So maximum number possible is 5. It can be less than 5, but by an even number. So 5 minus even number, say 2, 4, we can't subtract 6 because that will be minus 1. How a polynomial can number of roots as minus 1? Okay, now consider f of minus x for this part, minus x, minus 2x power 7, minus 3, minus even power, no change. Minus 10. Okay. For maximum number of negative root, we have to look at the sign changes among coefficient of which expression? F of minus x. So let's count number of sign changes. No. Here it is 1. And here also it is 1. Then, no. So it is what? 2. So therefore, we can say that number of negative roots of f of x equal to 0 can be maximum is 2. And by less than a less than an even number, so 2 or what? 0. Okay. Without actually solving the equation, we can't say by this rule that how many positive roots. It is, but we can say with this rule of sign that the number of roots can be 1, 3 or 5 which are positive, or the number of negative roots can be 0 or 2. This is about Descartes' rules of signs. Okay. Now, the next topic is quadratic equation in two variables, quadratic equation in two variables. You are familiar with the general form of the quadratic equation in two variables x and y, which is ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c. Isn't it? This is called quadratic equation in two variables. But whenever you face an equation like this, we can consider it is either in quadratic in x or quadratic in y. Okay, so considering we have more often considered quadratic in x, so let's consider considering quadratic in y. So write quadratic in y, by square plus 2hx plus fy plus ax square plus 2gx. We have written as quadratic equation in y. So can we express, y in terms of x? Yes, with the help of quadratic formula. Always remember, whenever you have to do something like expression in a quadratic expression in two variables, you can try this method. Consider it in either in quadratic in x or quadratic in y, and rest we are familiar with the usual quadratic. So what will be y equal to? Minus b, and here it in place of minus we have this, okay, plus minus under root b square minus 4a. By 2a, y equal to minus hx plus f plus minus h square x square plus 2fhx plus f square minus b a x square plus 2gx plus c by b. 2 we have cancelled. Now, one thing we have to notice, what if y and x are connected by a linear relation? What if y and x are connected by a linear relation? So that will represent a straight line, isn't it? Because if x and y in an equation are connected by a linear relation, then that equation represents a straight line. So actually, there are two values of y in terms of x over here due to quadratic equation. Now, we are going to find the condition that how we can have a linear relation in x and y. The only problem in linear equation here is this linear relation here is this square root sign. Isn't it? If this square root sign is not there, then oh, we are more than happy. Oh, so I should delete a square root sign? No. This square root sign can be managed if the expression under this square root sign is a perfect square. Okay, so now we write for linear relation in x and y, h square x square plus 2fhx plus f square minus abx square plus 2bgx minus bc, it is also minus, not plus, okay, must be a perfect square. That is, we can write this in terms of quadratic also. H square minus ab into x square plus 2 fh minus bg x plus f square minus bc is a perfect square. Okay, now when a quadratic expression is a perfect square, means a quadratic expression perfect square means it is a square of a linear expression. When it is that? When discriminant is 0. Remember a into x minus alpha whole square. Second case of sign scheme for quadratic. Now, this implies discriminant of this quadratic in x must be 0. Why must be 0? Because for linear relation in x and y, that square root sign should not be there. Okay. Now write the expression for discriminant of this quadratic in x. Okay. Four we can eliminate from right hand side. F square h square plus b square g square minus 2bfgh. And here h square f square minus ABF square minus BCH square plus AB square C. Now think of any term getting cancelled. Yeah. Any other? Let's see. B square g square minus 2bfgh plus abf square plus bch square minus ab square c equal to 0. We can take b common. This implies what? If B is 0, then what will happen? Either B is 0 or this factor is 0, isn't it? Look over here. We have considered quadratic in Y, and here the coefficient of Y square is B. So, if b is 0, then our whole theory will be wrong because it will not be a quadratic in y, okay? And we have considered it as quadratic in y. So, therefore, bg square minus 2fgh plus af square plus ch square minus abc equal to 0, that is ABC plus 2FGH minus AF square minus BG square minus CH square equal to 0. What condition we have arrived at? This is the condition on coefficients of this equation for which the expression AX square plus 2HXY plus BY square plus 2GX plus 2FY plus C can be resolved into two linear factors of x and y, linear relation. If this is usually represented by delta ABC plus 2FGH minus AF square minus BG square minus CH square equal to 0. If this condition is met, then this expression can be factorized into two factors, two linear factors of x and y. Okay. In determinant form, we write this expression, which ABC plus 2FGH minus AF square minus BG square minus CH square, as okay. This expression ABC plus 2FGH minus AF square minus BG square minus CH square is also referred as discriminant of this quadratic equation in two variable. So whenever you face a quadratic equation in two variables, just consider it as a normal quadratic equation, either in x or in y. Now, another small topic, equations reducible to quadratic means those equations are not actually quadratic, but they can be solved by reducing them into quadratic equation form. Okay, very small topic. Fine, let us see first example. Find the real roots of x plus 2 into x plus 3 into x plus 8 into x plus 12 equal to 4x square. Okay. Now, x plus 2, x plus 3, x plus 8, x plus 12. We may have an idea that what is 3 into 8? 24. 2 into 12? 24. So this bracket with this one and this one. First fourth bracket, x square plus 14x plus 24 into second third, x square plus 11x plus 24 is 4x square. Okay. Can we put x square plus like this? Isn't it? Some problem. Oh, what to do? Here it is x square. Can x be 0 here? No. X equal to 0 is not satisfying this equation. Fine, very good. So if x is not 0, we can divide this equation by x square. So x square plus 14x plus 24 by x. X square plus 11x plus 24 by x square. Now we have x plus 24 by x plus 14 into x plus 24 by x plus 11 equal to 4. T plus 14 into T plus 11 equal to T plus 14 into T plus 11 equal to 4, where T is what? X plus 24 by x, isn't it? So this is a quadratic. In t, t square plus 25t plus what? 14 into 11, 154 equal to 4. T square plus 25t plus 150 equals 0. Isn't it? Can we find t? Tell me. Or t is minus 25 plus minus under root 625 minus 600 by 2. Ten and minus 15. It is not the value of x. So for finding the value of x, we have to solve this equation. Or x square minus 10x plus 24 equal to 0. Or x square plus 15x plus 24 equal to 0. Okay. From here we are getting 4 and 6, and from here some irrational values will be there. Okay. So in this way we can solve. Now come to second. 64 into 3 power x whole square minus 84 into 3 power x into 4 power x plus 27 into 4 power x whole square. We can write like this. 9 power x we have written, 3 power x whole square. Now dividing by 3 power x into 4 power x, what we have? 64 Now, if we put 3 by 4 power x as t, we have 64t minus 84 plus 27 by t equal to 0. Isn't it? This implies 64t square minus 84t plus 27 0. Okay, now we can find the values of t, just mere calculation. Okay, can we find the roots? It is a quadratic. So these kind of equation are not directly quadratic, but we can always change into quadratic equation. Okay. I expect you to get the final answers of these questions. Now there is just calculation, nothing else. Okay. Now next small topic is inequalities involving a square root. Very much confusion students have in this. See, first of all, square root of a real number is defined for non-negative numbers. For example, square root of 2, 3, 5, 0 are defined, but square roots of minus 2, minus 5, these are not defined. So we must keep track that there should not be any problem on definition of square roots. So our first example is under root x square plus 6x plus 5 greater than 8 minus x. A square root sign is in the left side. Okay, listen carefully. For a square root to be defined, x square plus 6x plus 5 greater than or equal to 0, isn't it? What are the roots? Minus 5, minus 1, positive. Means whatever answer we get, that must satisfy this condition. Okay. Now also, a square root of a real number cannot be negative. Root 4 is 2, not minus 2. So square root of a real number cannot be negative. So it is clear that LHS cannot be negative. Now, case wise we solve. Case 1, RHS greater than or equal to 0. That is 8 minus x greater than equal to 0 or x less than equal to 8. Just do it carefully. If RHS is greater than or equal to 0, left side is a square root, cannot be negative. So we can square, both roots are not negative, positive, then we can square. So what we have? No change of inequality. X square minus 16x plus 64, 22x, 59, x greater than 59 by 22. See, x greater than 59 by 22 is okay. But these things must also satisfy. So, what numbers we should write on the number line to finding the solution from this case? Minus 5, minus 1, 59 by 22. From definition, it is like this. From case, we are solving for this case, x less than or equal to 8. So we have to write 8 also. And from solution, we have, so from this case, we are having what solution? Tell me. X belongs to 59 by 22 to 8, close. Okay. Now, this is the only solution? No. Another case. Is it okay that RHS is only positive? No. 8 minus x can be negative. So case 2, is RHS less than 0, that is 8 minus x less than 0. This implies x greater than 8. If x greater than 8, now what is this? RH is negative, so LHS greater than RHS is true as LHS is greater than equal to 0 and RHS is less than 0. Why? We are assuming RHS is negative and square root is either 0 or positive. So, a 0 or positive number is obviously greater than a negative number. So, this whole case will be a solution. This implies whole case will be a solution. Okay? Now, and what is the case? That is, x belongs to 8 to infinity. Yeah, defined, square root is defined. From 1 and 2, what is our final solution? We can write 59 by 22 to 8 closed, and from here 8 open to infinity. So we can write 59 by 22 to infinity. Now, second, for square roots to be defined, x minus 3, 2 minus x greater than or equal to 0, and 4x square plus 12x plus 11 greater than or equal to 0. Here, 2, 3, negative, sorry. Here it is negative according to sign scheme. So, for first square root to be defined, x should be between 2 and 3. And what about second? If you look at this second, why? Because the discriminant is negative and coefficient of x square is positive. So this expression will be always positive for any real value of x. So this square root will be defined for any real value of x. Okay. And being a square root, okay, both sides cannot be negative, positive. So, squaring does not affect the inequality. So, we can now square. We have x minus 3, 2 minus x less than 4x square plus 12x plus 11. So far, we have constraint on x is x should lie between 2 and 3. Because this square root must be defined. Now here it is, -x² - 2x + 3x this implies 5x² + 11x + 17 greater than equal to 0. It is true for all x belonging to R. Why? Because discriminant is less than 0. So answer will be what? All real values of x? No. Only this condition must be satisfied. If a square root is defined, then this inequality is always valid. Therefore, our answer should be x belongs to 2 comma 3. Okay. Now, go for worksheets. Today we have studied small topics, very few theory, mainly example based on sine scheme and quadratic. Okay, so go through worksheet. Thank you.